All of you are doing well, taking this adverse situation positively. I am here today with you to discuss about the edit, construction and standardization of tools in educational research. I have planned to discuss this in a phased manner, and as an introductory class, I am going to discuss with you about different types of research tool before going to discuss about the construction of it. And in a phased manner, I shall discuss about the construction and standardization of tools, its different phases and different principles, and as well as how to validate and sustain the reliability or other technical and practical qualities of a research tool. So here, the meaning of tools. Research tool. First, tool. It's a very common and popular word. Tool is a device or instrument. Suppose, for example, I have to cut vegetables. Here, the tool will be the knife. With the help of the knife, I shall cut the vegetable. So, it is a knife is the device here. With the help of which, I have performed the activities. In research, similarly in research also, research is a process or activity in which we have to collect data or information to make some generalizations, to come into some conclusions, or to search for some solution of problems, educational problems, etc. So on and so forth. So here, research tool, therefore, is a testing device for measuring a given event that may be questionnaire, it may be interview schedule, observation checklist, psychological test, assessment test, etc. So these are the instruments with the help of which we collect information about different performances, as it is a teaching learning process, and assess, evaluate, measure data that are authentic, reliable, observable, and measurable. All these types of data are developed by the researchers as per their objectives. So, next. So, there are lots of devices or tools in educational research. But selection of proper tools for data collection is one of the most important aspects in research. The same example I am drawing here. Suppose I have to cut the pieces of cloth. Here the tool or the device will be, I have to select the tool, and the proper tool will be the scissor. Only with the help of the scissor only I can properly cut the pieces of cloth, not the knife. Similarly, in research, we have to select proper tool for data collection. Suppose I have to collect data from 10 or 20 successful personality. To collect data about their reason behind, about their past life, what type of instrument or device will be appropriate? It will be interview schedule, because through interview schedule, in interview we can collect data, we can establish a rapport, we have to collect some deeper information. We have seen interview in our radio programs, in our TV programs, suppose Ananna or Satyame Bajarate, or like this, such kind of problems are there, coffee with Karan, such types of problems are there, where such types of tools are appropriate. Similarly, suppose we have to collect data from 500 or 1000 sample regarding some social situation. In that case, it is not possible for the investigator to contact each person and collect data. So here the questionnaire will be the appropriate data collecting device. And suppose we have to collect data about language development of the 3-year children. In that case, we have to choose the data collecting device observation setting. So it will be the appropriate tools, not the questionnaire, to collect data from the 3 years children. So selection of proper tools for data collection basically depends on the nature of information to be gathered, on the nature of the research design, on the nature of the sample size and sample status, on the basis of which different tools are selected, used, and then with the help of proper selection only we can acquire proper authentic observable data, and it will help us in serving the research purpose. So as a rule, education is a process that not only focuses on teaching learning evaluation but also teaching learning evaluation but also different in solution of different education related problems. So different tools are used. These are basically included that are popularly used are psychological and educational tests and inventories. These includes the assessment test, aptitude test, interest inventory, personality test, intelligence test, etc. And another forms are there. These are inquiry forms. The inquiry forms are a class of data gathering device which makes use of properly prepared proforma or forms or to inquiry into and seeking information about certain phenomena under study. Out of numbers of such tools, most used and abused also tool is questionnaire, along with which other types of tools such as attitude scale or opinioner, scorecard, checklist, etc. are also used. So another tool is interview. Here interview is a direct method of inquiry, a systematic method through which deeper information can be collected. Such types of interview may be structured or unstructured. In structured interview, we collect data in a structured way. Suppose I have to collect, interview with a big personality, suppose some academicians or educationists. I have to prepare the interview schedule beforehand, and to supplement it, I can also adopt the unstructured interview schedule also. So in both structured and unstructured interview schedule may be used for data collection. It depends on the situation and nature of the study. So another tool is observation. So this is a method. This method is mostly used in science, but in educational research too, it is adopted to observe different behavior of the children, particularly. And observation is particularly may be participatory or non-participatory. We shall discuss it in details. All these types of tools will be discussed in details, how we can structure such kind of tool, how it can be validated, or how we can sustain its reliability. All these aspects will be discussed later on. And another popularly used technique is sociometric technique. So sociometric scales are also used for quantitative study of the abstract and also qualitative aspects of different social phenomena. So as a good, so all these types of tools are used in educational research, and I think you all have a brief understanding about what is research tool. I am focusing here today only on research tools. In the next class, I would like to focus on the qualities of good research tools. So for today, thank you and goodbye.